o'clock, and I'd like to call the meeting of the Region Queens Municipality's Regular Council Tuesday, September 27th, 2022, to start. Call to order. Before I ask for any changes or approval of the agenda, I would like to remind council and all of our viewers that this Friday is National Truth and Reconciliation Day. Saturday, October 1st, is Treaty Day and the beginning of Mi'kmaq History Month. There is celebrations at the Hankstone Grounds on both days, Friday and Saturday. And I would like to remind people that Truth and Reconciliation Day honors the children who never returned home and the survivors of the Canadian residential school system. I would encourage all Queens County residents and members of council to attend events at Truth and Reconciliation Day and the Maui Owe on Saturday. And in honor of the children who never returned home and survivors of the residential school system, I believe it is fitting and we stand and provide a minute of silent reflection for those people. Before I ask for approval of the minutes, I will note that I sent an email respecting the minutes within our package. Item 7.6 shows the motion was unanimous, when in fact there was one abstention, so that would be 7-4-1 against. And those changes have been made in the minutes. Any other changes to the minutes? If not, I'll ask for approval of the minutes. Moved by Councillor Charlton, seconded by Councillor Gidney. All those in favor? Passed. Director Grant. At our last council meeting, we had a discussion respecting the policy for the maintenance of trees, which, as we all know, it is our public works department's goal to ensure that the streets that we travel upon that are owned by the Region of Queens remain safe and free of any physical site barriers. The MGA Act allows council through policy to allow staff to take action if they feel that there are trees which are posing a safety hazard to the traveling public. And our last meeting, we discussed this policy, which provides the ability of Sept to do. So there is a motion within the package. Counselor Gibney?
I recommend that the council region police municipality approve policy 95, maintenance of trees.
And then seconded by Counselor Hawks. Are there any questions of Director Grant? Or Director Grant, do you have anything else to add to this?
Nothing specific. I think we discussed it pretty good last meeting. Any questions?
Any questions? Hearing none, I'm going to ask for the question. All those in favor? Contrary? Pass. Thank you very much, Director Grant. Cost sharing of J-class roads, 2023-2024 fiscal year. Once again, we discussed this at our last council meeting under discussion. There were four roads put forward at that point in time for recommendation of sharing of these provincially owned roads. And what we need today is a motion because, as we know, we have to prioritize the roads. So there is a motion there. I asked what the procedure would be. And basically, it would run as a motion is made stating the priority order. You can either agree or disagree. If that motion is defeated respecting the priority order, then a new motion can be made. And we would continue until hopefully there is a motion that we could all agree on the priority order. So the floor is open for someone to make a recommendation. Counselor Merrill.
I move that the Council of Region of Queens Municipality submit the following J-class roads to Nova Scotia Public Works for consideration of cost sharing in 2023-2024. College Street from Shore Road to Pleasant Avenue, Roxbury Road, Oliver Street, and Fostertown Road. And that the roads be submitted in the following priority order. So that would be College Street from Shore Road to Pleasant Avenue, Roxbury Road, Oliver Street, and Fostertown Road.
So you have left them in the order of which they were. And that is seconded by Councilor Gidney.
Yes.
Is there any discussion on that priority order? Councilor Charlton?
I drove the roads that are in my area and they're all in terrible shape. I think that I'm okay with that. I just think in the future it would be nice if we could come up with some sort of policy where we could score these roads so that, you know, it's a fair system of how we choose, because I just think that would be helpful moving forward. I mean, the College Street one is a no-brainer given the all the busing in the schools and things like that, but the other, I mean, every road is bad, so.
Right, they're all those J-class roads need repair. Any other comments? Deputy Mayor Muse, would you take the chair? I am going to vote against the motion, not because of that I disbelieve the priority, because I think the priority is right, but I simply am voting against cost sharing of provincial roads. I believe we should encourage our MLA to place some of these roads, especially the priority number one. The provincial government does upgrade and pave other J-class roads in the province. And as a municipality that we own our own streets, if we're going to be putting money in streets, I really think it should be in streets that we own.
I think we've heard in the past that when we went through amalgamation, the province is, there's some dispute over how much the province owes us for maintaining our own roads. And if we're that short, what is it, $50,000 a year, something like that, that this should be paid for by the province.
Any other comments?
That's John.
understanding that these G-class roads are slated under the MGA, is that correct? No?
No, it's a service exchange agreement back from 1994.
So there's an agreement in place, so until the province changed that agreement, these roads won't get done. Like, there's other municipalities that put money in their budgets every year to do these J-class roads. I think our residents deserve better roads, and I think that this is, unless we're willing to cost share, I don't think they'll happen. So I'm concerned about all that.
Any other comments? Okay, hearing none. All those in favor of the motion? Opposed?
Thank you, Deputy Mayor. And it takes us to our discussion 8.1. So within the package, you have information from the online reports as well as minutes from the public hearing, and as we know, part of the mandatory municipal electoral boundary review is to consult with the public on what the public views is in the betterment for the public interest. I was surprised when I looked at the online comments, they were overwhelmingly in support of 6
issues. I think if you look at the list there, I think when it asks what your favorite opinion was, that was probably the default position on the survey, because when people said they wanted 7 or they wanted 8, it still defaulted to 6 on that list.
Yeah.
When you look at the people explain what they wanted, a lot of people said they wanted 7 councillors, but it defaulted to the favored opinion option being 6. So I think when they were filling it out, if they didn't change that box, it almost looks like that was the default position.
I noticed that for several, yeah. Mr. Ross, though he did say 8 councillors, each member president 8, and there were some that said 7 councillors should be able to serve constituents, and then that did say 6 councillors. 6 councillors plus mayor, and then again it says 6 councillors. There was another one, the council's recommendation. I agree with council's recommendation of 7, but then it was 6.
Yeah.
And then there were comments respecting some residents felt that Liverpool will always be favored having 3 councillors. There was a explanation of no boundaries, simply everyone being elected at large from the entire county, which would place the top number of votes. And when you consider that we are an amalgamated region and the bulk of the population is in Liverpool, Brooklyn, and Milton, to have all councillors elected at large would make it very difficult for anyone from the North Queens area to ever have a seat. So I think it works well in towns. I don't think that's going to encourage councillors to get out and tour the entire Queens County and to become more familiar with what's going on. So the floor is open for discussion on what direction, keeping in mind it will be the final decision of the UARB, and they do receive the information from the public sessions.
Any
I spoke in favor of putting eight counselors in the next time because I thought it gives us an even number of counselors with the mayor having a deciding vote, so we end up with less tied votes, less potential tied votes. It looked like it was more community oriented instead of piecing pieces together to get the right numbers. It looked like a better breakdown along community lines. You know, some people think that we're doing it because we don't want the workload, we want less counselors or less constituents, and I don't think that's fair. I think we want better representation for the communities, and that option also gives less perceived power to the town of Liverpool, which right now has more counselors. More counselors have a portion of the town of Liverpool, so the perception is that they've got more cloak. I think that the eight option has three counselors with a piece of Liverpool and five without, so it kind of evens the balance around the county. And I think anybody who thinks that adding one more counselor is going to bankrupt the municipality grossly overestimates what we get paid as counselors.
Other comments? Deputy Mayor Muse?
I think sticking to the seven that we have now and changing some of the boundaries, like Councilor Gidney and I, we tie in some areas and it doesn't really make sense, so just fix up the boundaries and stick to the seven that we have now.
Other comments?
Really does not matter to me. I just am looking at all the public comments and six definitely is sticking out there. I guess if you look at all three different options, you know, in option one, which is currently Deputy Mayor Muse's district now, we've got 10% of Liverpool, and then district two would have 40%, district three would have 50, so there's three counselors that are in the Liverpool side in regard to those comments earlier. And in option two, there would be two. And in option three, there's three. So they're still, given the size of it, you're going to have at least two. So the difference is the odds, really. I would say it would be the six or the seven that I would be in favor of. So. Just to clarify. So you're asking for majority opinion on something, which gets noted to the jury.
It will. This is a discussion matter, so it would go as a if people are decided today. The date is the end of this year. So by the end of December, a decision has to be sent to the UARB.
So we still have a walk-up.
So this is still a discussion. This is still in discussion. It can remain in discussion. I was looking at this and remembering way back in the municipality days when actually Western Head was joined with Port Jolly, Port Matune, and those areas. There's time, you know, if council wished to look at a differencing, knowing that we have to keep within those variances as required, though we could ask for an exception if one variance was made greater than it should be. We could ask the UARB for a decision. But you'll notice, and as to Councillor Brown's, you know, many people noted who called six said because of the cost, and you're right, it's a very minimal cost, probably less than $30,000 a year by the time you add in a counselor's pay and their travel. So it's minimal in the grand scheme of things, but it is the public perception. So, you know, but the floor is yours. to debate, Deputy Mayor Muse?
So, say we go to 6 or 8, when does it happen? The next election?
Never.
So nothing happens until the next one?
Yes. If I may just clarify, to Councilor Charlton's point, and the mayor's point, the deadline to have this submitted to the URB is the end of December. However, we still have to write the application and prepare all the documentation and stuff. So if you decide tonight to send it to the next meeting for a recommendation, it'll take us probably at least 4 to 6 weeks to do the application submitted. So it won't actually be submitted at this, based on the current process, till about the end of November. And so if you delay it much more than that, we're into December and we won't meet the deadline because of the advance card. So there is a little bit of time, but don't delay it for 2 months. That's what I'm saying.
So what are the thoughts in the back? Councilor Hawks?
I look at option 1 and option 2. Or 1 and 8. Option 1 is for those 5 and 6 area, they are big, big areas, right? And as far as distance wise, could be 15 miles in either direction, right? So you have 30 mile range. And I think it's, as it is now with option 2, it's a big area, but that makes it even bigger. And I suppose I could go with option 3 or 8 districts and small them up, but I'm still in favor of 7.
Keeping 7 electoral districts as listed in option 2?
Yeah.
So we have had various opinions. Yeah, we have 6, 7, and 8.
That's how we got here.
6, 7, and 8. So in the minds of the constituents, what is the best way to truly represent the people in this county?
I still think if you look at having six councilors, you have 3 of them with a piece of Liverpool, it still looks like Liverpool has 50% of the votes. And I think that perception is really big in the community, that, you know, we all know that Liverpool is the 600-pound gorilla in our room, but to set it up like that, I think it makes it even worse. I think we have to look at 7 or 8 to keep, you know, some perception that Liverpool doesn't make all the decisions.
A question to the CAO. Would it be unrealistic to, and I'm not sure because it's based on population, but 10% of Liverpool, would that be about equal to, say, the amount of people in Western Head, Moose Harbor? And then Mercy Point, Mount Pleasant, and 50% of Liverpool. Would it make any sense to take the tip from Western Head, Moose Harbor, and join them with other coastal communities, and then that counselor would have a greater share of the Liverpool area? Because Mount Pleasant, Mercy Point are basically outskirts of Liverpool.
You could certainly do that. It wouldn't be contiguous, which is, we try to keep it contiguous, but it doesn't necessarily have to connect to each other. So just to clarify, it's based on voters, not population.
Yeah, voters.
So it's based on voters. But if council wished us to add some of Mercy Point, Western Head, that area to another area to keep Liverpool more intact, less separation of 3 different councillors having part of Liverpool, we can certainly do that as part of the application. Yes.
So as to that, so I guess I'll ask the question. Do you feel that we should reduce the amount of counselors who represent part of Liverpool? Like, that's the first question. Should we try to find a way so that perhaps only two counselors are representing Liverpool and the other remaining counselors represent rural parts? Councilor Charlton?
Just to clarify, isn't that exactly what Offington is doing? Because it takes Deputy Mayor Muse out of the 10%.
35 and 50.
But still three.
But it still has.
Oh, I just missed District 5, 15%.
District 5, still has.
Sorry, my apologies.
There really is no option here that gives.
Takes away.
That takes, that reduces to two counselors for the Liverpool.
If I may, and just based on the discussion under option two, if you were to take the 15% from Milton and leave Milton intact, Milton would be under the 1261. Right now they're way above it, 8% above. They'd be probably 7 or 8% below, but that would keep Milton intact. Mm-hmm. Then you could move that into one of the other two Liverpool districts to make them a little bigger. And so they would, one or both of those other Liverpool districts would be, so if you hypothetically took District 2 and moved that up, took the 15% from the Milton one and put it into District 2, that would give you two with, just two that have major parts of Liverpool. But District 2 in this particular scenario would be over the plus or minus 10%, but I think you'd have an argument that you could argue with the URB that it makes sense to allow that one to be slightly over 10%.
People have 50% of Liverpool.
Instead of 35, would be 50%, yeah. And then the District 3 would be 50% as well. And you could change that. You could say District 3 is gonna be 55 or 60, and District 2 would be 40 or 45. You could play those numbers a little bit. But if that's an option council wants to go with, we can move those numbers around to balance it out. It's
I could be very supportive of that motion.
And from the councilor's point of view, Liverpool is a pretty tight area to have to do. So even though you may have more of the voters, it's a lot easier, it's much easier to access them, to see them, to attend to them. Councilor Charlton?
I'm in favor of that. We could split it up. Like, I think there's value in that comment, and I think it needs to be fair, and there shouldn't be multiple counselors that are representing just Liverpool or bigger parts of it. I'm just looking too, if you took District 5, the Milton, 15%, you take that one out, but then it's possible that maybe District 3 has more of Liverpool and the Brooklyn Sandy Cove part reshuffles into the Brooklyn part. Like, there's probably some moving pieces that could be adjusted there a bit. Or maybe.
District 4 Brooklyn already has 6.42%. It's already high.
Or maybe that part of Sandy Cove goes under District 5 with Milton.
The difficulty with that is that Sandy Cove is a large number of voters. I think it's like 400 or 450. Oh. So if you try to move any part of Brooklyn, it's a substantial number.
So basically, if we end up under the consensus that if we can split Liverpool under two councillors, then staff can bring that back before, like with the recommendation rather, we would see what that looked like then, or just trying to understand what would come back.
So if you would, it depends. So right now, like District 3 is 6% above the average. Mm-hmm. So if you were to change that to say 55%, that would get you close to 10% probably. And then if you change District 2 from 35 to 45, that will probably get you close to the 10% as well.
Okay.
So those would be pretty even. So that's, if that's what you're suggesting, I would suggest that's what you do. Mm-hmm. Rather than move the whole 15 to District 2, because then they'll probably be at 12 or 13%, but that would skew it. And then the URB would come back and say, why don't you move those a little bit because they're both Liverpool. So I think if we did a 45 and 55 and take it out of Milton, that would get us pretty close to a plus or minus 10. And that's what the motion would be at the next meeting. for a future meeting, and then if council agrees to that, then staff will go through the process of, we have to go street by street, count house by house, to get the final numbers, so that takes quite a while to do.
So do you want to see that come back next council as a discussion item? Basically, that we take that 15% off Milton, leave it as an intact community, and divvy up the 15% between the two districts, 2 and 3?
I would like to see it come back like that. I do like option two, because I like how it has, Port Medway and Danesville and the Eastport Medway, along with Brooklyn and Beach Meadows. I just think it aligns it up better, because Councilor Brown's is crazy, really. His should be able to pull that in. It's just split too much. So I do like option two much better, and I do like scenarios.
And regardless of what councilor represents the current district Councilor Brown serves, it's from the whole length of the Medway River, so
yes.
It's a huge district, Laval all the way down to Port and everything. So does someone want to make a recommendation that this come back, or
Councilor Fancy? Before we go forward, you know, the person being affected, the Milton district should at least be heard from. I believe that the way it has been run, I have no problem with it, because when it was first put above and Liverpool, part of Liverpool became part of that, it really did cause some confusion. People are used to that now being part of that district. I don't really want to see a change. Everything is close together. It's easy to get to everybody. It's still nice when we're that close, when Milton's that close to Liverpool, to have at least a part of Liverpool too. So I kind of like it as it is. Be able to represent people on Bristol in particular. And I go along with what Councilor Miro said. When I looked at this initially, I said, well, you know, option two is almost perfect, because it's starting to divide up some of the areas where Councilor Brown and Councilor Miro were, you know, like Councilor Brown's got such a big district, from way back or down around, that Councilor Miro is going to be taking that, and then I think it's going to actually help have some use too. So it gets I think it's almost a perfect scenario to me, the way it is.
Councilor Charlton?
So I'll make a motion to move this to come back under a recommendation. Recognizing that there's representation of only two councillors under Liverpool.
I'll second it.
Seconded by Councilor Brown. Any further discussion? If not, I'll ask for the question. All those in favor? Contrary? 7-1. Thank you. And that is the end of our public part of the agenda. I would have a motion to move in camera. We have two contract negotiations.
So moved.
Moved by Councilor Romero, seconded by Councilor Charlton. All those in favor? Pass. We have one matter that has come out of in camera, and that is 9.2. If someone would so make that recommendation. Councilor Romero.
I move that the Council of Region of Queens Municipality agrees to enter into an agreement with Holly Murphy Stone and Michael Murphy with regards to the establishment of an outdoor community pool.
And that is seconded by Councilor Charlton. Are there any comments? Councilor Brown?
I'd just like to say that we've talked about this a lot of times around the council chambers, and we couldn't come to a decision because we didn't have the terms of the agreement from the donors. And now that that's in place, I think we're in a position to move ahead and get this pool built for the community.
Any other further comments? Councilor Merrill?
I think that the terms of the agreement are great, and I think it's a wonderful gift for the residents of Queens County.
Any comments? I guess my closing comment would be thank you very much to Holly Murphy Stetton and to Michael Murphy for taking a vote of our community. And the other comment will be that the terms of the agreement are confidential, as requested by the donor, and that includes the gift amount and the timelines. I want to ask for the question. If any, all in favor?